Why is the lighting so bad?
So hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's Ahmed Khan here. In this video, I'm gonna go over 12 qualities that extremely successful people have and the average people actually don't. This video is actually not going to be a very long one, but I'm telling you, if you do not have the 5 minutes to invest in yourself to learn something that will be valuable to you in your life, then I don't know what you're doing. And without rumbling much, let's get straight to the content because I'm currently vlogging at a beautiful place that's in Istanbul and I'm a little scared and feeling a little weird because of the fact that that's one of the first times that I'm ever vlogging in public. People are staring at me, but it does not matter. Let's get started with the first thing. Highly successful people do not give things up when it gets hard. If you don't want to sacrifice for your dream, then that means the ultimate sacrifice is going to be basically your dream. If you don't want to sacrifice for your dream, then your dream is going to be the sacrifice that you have to give. And that's a pretty basic logic. So the first thing is basically you have to not give up when things get hard. If you are studying for an exam and if you got a very low point in one exam, then you just cannot give up. That's a tough point of the challenge and it's basically how it's supposed to be. Two, extremely successful people generally do not waste time on social media. Yes, they may have an Instagram account, they may have a YouTube channel, or they may have something else, but they don't really waste time on social media. They're not going to, for example, Instagram Reels and then just scrolling through Instagram Reels for like 30 minutes or so. They're not going to a YouTube channel and just watching every single one of their videos. This is not what they're doing. They might be creating content, but they're definitely not wasting time on social media. And three, extremely successful people do not hang out with losers. The people who you hang out with are basically one of the most like basic things that you can change. At the same time, one of the most important things that you have to change basically in order to be successful. I'm not telling you to leave all your friends, but what I'm telling you is if you are hanging out with 5 losers, then guess who is going to be the 6th one. At the same time, if you are, for example, hanging out with 5 millionaires, then guess who is going to be the next one? Exactly you. Why? Because your tribe will basically shape your identity, and your identity is the key to becoming successful. At the same time, if your identity is not at the right point, then it's also the basic thing that will basically determine if you're going to be successful or not, and that's basically the hard, cold truth. So if you are hanging out with losers, then just don't do it, because extremely successful people do not hang out with losers. They also hang out with people who are also successful. So guys, I just came home and I realized that while on the way, while I was coming home, I was looking through my footage and I deleted some of them, including the 4th tip and the 5th tip, so this time I have to shoot them again, but this time at home. 4, extremely successful people do not think that just a formal education is enough for life. They also know that personal development and improving yourself is absolutely needed. This can be through books, this can be through podcasts, this can be through interacting with people who are more successful than you, but this is absolutely needed. So do not just think that if you're getting a normal education, a formal education, that is not enough. You have to improve yourself, and improving yourself 1% every single day is absolutely key. Read books, listen to podcasts, go meet other people who are more successful than you, and do whatever you can to get yourself to a better position tomorrow and improve yourself every single day, even if it's just 1%, because it's gonna double down, it's gonna be a huge number at the end of a couple of years. And 5, do not be impatient. Successful people are not impatient. I know that I'm absolutely not really allowed to talk about this because I'm just a 17-year-old person, but at the same time, I'm telling you that great things take time. When I'm on YouTube, when I'm making videos, it's not gonna get to a point where it's successful in just 1 year. Maybe it's not gonna get to a successful point in 2-3 years. That's exactly why we should be sacrificing for the things that we actually want over the things that are just feeling good at this exact moment. And 6, successful people do not hope for a miracle. They do not wait for something surprising that will be happening to them that will make them successful. No, that's exactly not what they're doing. They get their hands dirty and they do the work, and that's why they are successful. You're not supposed to be successful in 2 months. You're not supposed to be successful in 2 years. Heck, I've been making videos for I think 1 year and 2 months at this point, and still we're not seeing any actually huge results, and that's what's supposed to happen. If you're not gonna get your hands dirty, if you're expecting for some miracle, then you're definitely not gonna be successful, and that is the tip number 6. 7, successful people do not neglect their health. And I'm not here saying like every successful person works out every single day, they have a perfect diet, they sleep 8 hours a day. No, that's exactly not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is basically if you are sick, if you are ill, then it doesn't mean anything that you're successful. It does not mean how much money you have in your bank account, how much success you had in the past. If you are sick and if you're in your deathbed, then just does not mean anything. That's why you should take care of your health. That's why you should be probably exercising, not maybe every single day, but hopefully a couple of times in the week. And that's why you should not really eat bad food every single day. Just try to have a better diet, and that's the key to success. 8, Successful people do not confuse being confident with being arrogant. You should be confident in yourself. You should be confident in your skills. You should be confident in your work, in what you do. But at the same time, you should not be arrogant, because arrogance means that you're basically telling other people that you are better than them. And in the long run, it's just going to hurt you. It's not going to help you in any shape or form. Yes, you might be seeing those lone wolf stuff that some teenagers generally fell into when they think about self-improvement and stuff, but that's absolutely not true. It's not a lone wolf game. It's basically a team game where you're going to be successful with your friends, with your family. That's how it's supposed to happen. That's why be confident in yourself, in your abilities, in your skills, but at the same time, do not be arrogant. And 9, do not underestimate the importance of basically setting goals. I talked about a Harvard study in a couple of videos earlier, and that's something really important. Someone with a purpose, someone with a goal is absolutely much more, I would say, dangerous than a person who does not have a goal, who does not know what he's doing. That's exactly why do not underestimate the importance of setting goals, and do not underestimate setting yourself smart goals. Don't just tell people, this is what I'm going to do. Tell people exactly how you are going to do it. You should not just have aspirations that you want to do in your life. It shouldn't be like a bucket list that you want to achieve. What you should do is you should basically make an actionable plan. This is incredibly important in whatever it is that you want to achieve, even at school, even in YouTube, even in business, whatever you want to do. Have a goal, at the same time have an actionable plan that you are going to be working on, because without having an actionable plan, your goal is basically just going to be an aspiration. It's not going to be a goal, it's just going to be a dream. Goals are basically dreams with a deadline. That's really important. 11. Successful people do not let other people choose their future for themselves. Let's say they have a passion, they go for it, they try to become the best in that in the world, and they basically try to become a world-class person in that field. That might be YouTube, that might be business, that might be whatever it is, anything else that you can think of. But at the same time, they do not let other people choose their future for them. So if you have a dream, if you have a passion, go for it. Absolutely put in the work and try to achieve the goal that you're actually setting your mind to. And that's really important. Do not underestimate yourself, and at the same time, do not let other people tell you what to do in your life. And 12th, the last thing is basically do not let your emotions dictate your actions. You might be sad, then you're still gonna study if you wanna be successful. You might be heartbroken, but you're still gonna film that video. Well, I'm not heartbroken, but I'm filming the video, so that's what I'm supposed to be doing. You might be depressed, but you still have to do the thing, do the work, if you want to be successful. Sometimes your emotions are the things that are going to keep you back in your comfort zone. You just have to be able to tell those emotions, like, F off, I gotta do the work, I gotta study, I gotta go to the gym, I gotta do all these stuff because I want to be successful, because I want to have a better future for myself. And that's basically it. I have been filming this video outside at a beautiful spot here in Istanbul, and it's been really weird because people have been staring at me like I'm a weirdo that has a camera. So I wouldn't really mind if you guys dropped a like to this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you. I'm really dark at this point. So thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.